Hello folks, Matthew Peterson here with another YouTube video, and I'm starting up a series called Power Apps 101. What you really need to know to get started on your Power Apps journey, and also pick up a few things if you've done Power Apps in the past. And what we're going to explore are galleries inside of your Canvas applications. All right, so what I have here is I have a Canvas application that has nothing on it. Now, we're not building out a full application here, getting you your basics to galleries, because these could be one of the hardest controls to get used to right in the beginning. So, with that being said, let's start putting in a gallery. Galleries are all used about showing data. So the way that this would be done is I'd come up here to my insert ribbon, and then I come on down to gallery. Now, if you search for gallery, you'll see that there's a lot of different galleries out there. The one we're going to be using here today is a vertical gallery. So when I click on vertical gallery, I'm going to get a pop-up because galleries are here to show data. And the first thing it's going to say is, hey, what data do you want me to show in your gallery? Galleries can show multiple records of data. This is what we like to do. We can put buttons and action icons and all sorts of good stuff. So what I'm going to use is a data source. It could be any data source of your choosing, but I have a data source. It could be an Excel file, a SQL table, a SharePoint list. So I'm going to search for one of my data connectors that I have and then click on my data connector. And I'm just going to bring in some park category or park information here. All right. But again, it could just be a SharePoint list that you point to. I'm just pointing to a SQL table. Now, in this case, I now have the gallery. Now, with the gallery, there are really two main parts to every gallery. You have what we call the whole gallery, and then we have what's called the special part, the template cell. So let's talk about the whole gallery first. A few things to note. You know if you have the whole gallery selected is if you have bubbles around the entire gallery control, which I have here. Second thing is, how do I get the whole gallery selected? Well, you have a few options. Option one is you can, with nothing selected, so I got the screen selected, pick anywhere in the gallery except for the first record here. So if I click here, whole gallery, click here, whole gallery. And option number two is use that friendly tree view over here and just select the gallery control on the left. Now, what do we typically do when the whole gallery is selected? Big design changes, things like size, location, the data source, the layout. And we're going to do all of those right here. So I'm just going to do some sizing and location. So when I hover over, I get my four arrows, just kind of bring it over and bring it on down. Can make it as big, as small as I want. And maybe I'll shorten it up here a little bit. So size and location, my data source can be monitored over here. I can choose a different data source if I wanted to, if I had brought it in as a data connection, and I could do it also from the data right here. Now, the next thing I want to do is a color decision. I want to fill the color in. So with the gallery selected, I'm going to come up to my property drop-down window. I'm going to go to the fill property. And this is where I can put in my own RGBA code, or I can use some of the predefined colors that come with Power Apps. So if I want to go with teal today, I can say color, tab that over, dot, and then teal, just using some Power FX here. And so now we see something we didn't see earlier, this little rectangle separator that's in between. And we'll come back to that in a little bit. Now from here, and I'll just zoom in now just a little bit more so we can see this part of the screen. What if I don't like this layout? Well, right now the layout is image, title, and subtitle. And that simply means there are three data controls to display data. And if I come on over and I expand this in my tree view, you can see subtitle, title, and image. So each of those are pointing to item, record, value, and we can change that, which we'll learn how to do in a few moments. Now, so I've done the big overall design decisions. So what's this special location up here? The first record of every gallery. This is called your template cell. One of the easiest ways to select the template cell is when you have your gallery selected, click on that black pencil icon at the top. Now you'll see the bubbles just around the first row. Now, why do we call it the template cell? Well, it's because when you make it bigger or smaller or anything you do inside, all the other records are going to follow suit. So if I come up here and I make it smaller again, we can see that they're all now getting smaller. Now, what if you want to change what's showing in your gallery? Well, let's say I don't like the layout. Well, if I don't like the layout, I can technically do it with the template cell selected, or I could have the whole gallery selected, and I could choose layout from up at the top or layout from the right-hand side. I'll do it here because it's a little bit easier to see. And I'm just going to go with an image and a title. So now that means in my tree view, I have two data controls, the image control and the title control. Now, let me show you one of the easy ways to point your data to the values you want without having to write a formula. When you have the whole gallery selected, if you click on fields at the top, it says, oh, your title. It's pointing to the address column on your data source. Is that what you want? Well, maybe I want the park name. So I'll choose park name here, and it writes and points to the park name column. Now for the image, you can't do it that way. So we're gonna learn the official way if you never use this fields little panel here. So let's go explore this title control. So I can either select it in the template cell, or I can select it over here in the tree view. And this is what's happening. It's pointing to the park name column, and it's writing the formula thisItem.parkName. Whenever I see the word this item, not just in galleries, but in other places in the app, I always think for this record dot, what value do I want to reference? So right now it's pointing to the park name. Well, let's go take a look at the image control. Now again, if I select it in the whole gallery, it selects the whole gallery. If I want to modify the image control, I select it in the tree view, or I select it in the template cell. So I'm just gonna come on over and select it in my template cell. And right now there is no formula, it's a sample image. Well, I'm gonna point it to a column that I have URLs with the pictures hosted. So I'm gonna say this item dot site image URL. And now I'm getting a nice little picture here. So we've learned how we can do a few modifications to our galleries. Let's learn a few more. What if we don't like the rectangle here? Well, again, actually, I'm sorry, it's called our separator. I could go to the separator and I could choose a different color. So again, I'm in the template cell. So as I'm doing things here, it's gonna modify everything. And I'll go with color. Let's go here with color dot, put in some gold here. Kind of Jaguars-ish colors here. So now again, we made a change in the template cell. Now what you'll notice is if you play your application in these new galleries that were updated a year or so ago, when you click on a record, it's gonna bold the font and it's gonna put a rectangle. I like for it to be a little bit more explicit in what my users have selected. So a common gallery basic here. Again, we're going over the basics in this 101 series. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select my entire gallery. And the goal is for the cells to be different colored based on if the record has been selected. And the property that does that is called our template fill property. So I'm gonna go to template fill. So right now it's set to clear. So every cell is clear, but the background color of the gallery is shining through. Well, I'm gonna say, you know what? Let's do an if statement. If I need to refer to the record. So I say this item. So I'm gonna say, hey, if this record dot, now I don't need a value, I wanna do a check. It's called is selected. So if this item is selected, comma, I just choose a color because I'm dealing with a color property. So I'll go with color dot antique white, and then I'll close that off. And now you'll notice as I play the application, when I have my individual, so I would make better color design decisions here. You can make fun of me in the comments all you want, but we're seeing the execution of it. So those are some really common things to do with your galleries in terms of the design. Now I'm gonna show a few extras here and then I'll, you know, wrap this thing up. So the only thing is it's very rectangular, you know, in nature. So a little trick here is if you wanted to make it look a little bit more modern, if you go into your screen and you put in a control called a container. So I'm gonna take this container control and I'm gonna bring it on over here and make it a little bit bigger. And now I'm gonna take this gallery that I just made, I'm gonna cut that gallery out. So I'm gonna cut it, and then I'm gonna paste that into my container. And you might say, well, why paste it and what is this gonna make it look different? Well, now I'm just gonna have it take up the whole gallery here. And one thing that you'll start to see once I move my container over, and I'm just kind of move my container up just a little bit. I'm gonna come over here to this drop shadow effect and I'm gonna make it extra bold. So I'm gonna make it extra bold. So now when I go and I hit play, now it looks like the gallery is hovering. And you can even see that there's this little rounded out edge to the container and I have the gallery in the container. So one little thing, and you can mess with the border radius of your container as well by coming over here, making it bigger if you want to. So the last thing I'm gonna show is, well, what if you want more in your gallery? This is a tricky part here. So let's say I want to bring in another label to show. Well, what you would think is you would click on your gallery and you would think, go and say, I'm going to insert, and I'm going to insert a text label or whatever control you want. But what we notice is it puts it in the gallery, puts it in the control, as you can see here. It's not in each and every record. So you might already be saying, well, Matt, you said earlier that whenever you want every row to respond to something, you need to do that action in the template cell. And you are exactly correct. So here's the proper way of how you put more controls in your gallery. You select your gallery to begin with. You go into your template cell. So I click that black pencil icon. Then you insert whatever idea you want. So if you want another text label, bring in a text label. And now you can see that we now have a new text label for each and every record. So those are some of the really big gotchas to know about your galleries. Hopefully this starts you off with the beginning phases of it, and stay tuned to the rest of the series where I'm going to start to break down some of these other commonly used controls and the basics that you need to know in order to use them inside of your Canvas applications. So hopefully you enjoyed, and if that's the case, I'll see you in one of the next YouTube videos down the road. Thanks so much. If you're interested in learning more about Canvas apps, I have a great course and lots of courses on our on-demand learning platform, and you can use a code in the description below to see all the different courses. And the first one I would start off with is Introduction to Canvas Apps.